executive started out, actually. Sadly, with my mother passing away when I was 7 years old, and she was visiting a hospital in Jordan. As a result, just hearing about it during my life, hearing about the fact that she'd done this, she was trying to do it, and people are wanting to grow up and be like her. I often went and visited the hospital she died at Buffina, and basically got interested more in the administration side of hospitals, because that's possibly the only part that I understood. Was there anything specific you really wanted to bring to the hospital? I spent a lot of time with my father in hospital, probably the last 8 months of his life, when he was fighting cancer. There were some days when I'd kind of go home and think, wow, you know, it's a hard place to get well. I think that having a human place and feeling that children could feel home, that it wasn't very stifling, was one part of it, and that it was a place where they felt they could get well. When my daughter Janina first kind of running, I panicked because it was my first child and said to shake my mom about the children, but then realised that there was one.
You have two wonderful children, Janina and I, and I do with five. How involved in that?
Janina saw I think a man in South Sudan who was starving a couple of weeks ago, and I saw that she'd written a letter to the World Food Programme and donated her life savings, which was £160.26. That was one way to start. It was very, very, very good.
What advice do you have for parents who might be struggling with their own children's weight and fitness?
I think it's a very big issue in this region because of the availability of good food, which is a blessing in many ways. And I think that over the last 40 years, there's been a huge change in lifestyle, from one that was generally outdoors, and it was one that was involved in a lot of walking, a lot of fitness, very little variety or choice in food, and what food was available was healthy. But the introduction of fast foods, a lot of them. I do think that, you know, the introduction of the speed at which modern communications is also progressing is another factor for young people. The fact that they can spend to be a huge to get kids back outdoors really, and interested and in love with sports. I have a 1 hour a day on your iPhone or your iPad rule in the house. Luckily, actually, from when they were literally both 5 days old, and I was out of hospital then, I used to take them out in the pram at least twice a day for about 2 hours. When you introduce school, and most kids have access to digital media, and they talk about having their own iPhones, they talk about having their own. I just said that there's no iPad or iPhone at meal times, and that's when we talk as a family, it's really good to get them passionate about sports because they enjoy it so much. The trick is finding which is something that they enjoy rather than you enjoy. Has a love for horses but also for art. I try not to condone it at all, but I'm really pleased that she loves her time on horses. Zaid also, but Zaid loves it. He loves driving, off-road driving, trekking, camping, anything like that. I spent, you know, hours behind the computer and go away in the evening and think, okay, well, I think I achieved quite a lot today. And then you meet someone who's a nurse and realise that they've put in a long shift, and they've probably comforted a few people who were extraordinarily sad. They might have helped family that are